saying the president needs to make that move so that Congress, the administration, and our allies can openly discuss the actions necessary to respond to this threat. Tonight, four sources with knowledge of the matter tell NBC News that threat refers to a Russian military capability, with two of those sources specifying it refers to Russia's military capabilities in space. We pressed the president's national security advisor about Turner's warning.
Can you tell Americans that there's nothing they have to worry about right now in terms of what he describes as a national security threat?
In a way, that question it is impossible to answer with a straight yes, right? Because Americans understand that there are a range of threats and challenges in the world. I'm confident that President Biden, in the decisions that he is taking, is going to ensure the security of the American people going forward.
A top House Democrat is urging calm.
There's really no cause for panic or alarm around this particular piece of intelligence.
And tonight, this from the House Speaker.
I want to assure the American people there's no need for public alarm. Steady hands are at the wheel. We're working on it.
Two U.S. officials tell NBC News President Biden has been tracking the threat and directed his national security advisor to engage with top lawmakers, with a meeting already set for tomorrow. The U.S. has long been concerned about Russia's missile and nuclear capabilities, as well as its anti-satellite weapons systems.
Peter, you also have new reporting this evening about President Biden's interview with the special counsel, Robert Hur.
Lester, President Biden became heated, you'll remember, responding to the special counsel's assertion that he could not remember within several years when his son Beau died. Last week, the president criticized her for asking him about it.
How in the hell dare he raise that? Frankly, when I was asked the question, I thought to myself, wasn't any of their damn business.
But tonight, NBC News has learned that Hur never asked that question, according to two people familiar with the interview last fall. They say it was the president, not Hur or his team, who first introduced Beau Biden's death. The sources say the president got the date, May 30th, correct, but not the year. Lester?
Peter Alexander of the White House, thank you.